But I'm getting off the subject, I'm sorry. But there are so many fascinating tales to tell you. Well, let's see now, where were we? Oh, yes. Let me see now, you have your implements, and you have your magic circle. Good. Shall we proceed? But remember that magic is not for the faint-hearted. You can't be too careful when dealing with demons. And you wouldn't want to spend eternity in the fires of hell now, would you? So hard. You stand there in your robes, armed with your wand, your bloodstone, and all your implements of magic. But be sure you have no base metal on your person, only gold and silver to throw at the spirits if the need arises. The brazier is burning. Sprinkle a pinch of incense on it. Then a pinch of sulfur and a few drops of brandy. Good brandy, please. As the flames leap up, pronounce these words. I offer you, O Adonai, this purest incense as I offer this charcoal made of lightest wood. I offer it, O great and potent Adonai, Ilium, Eriel, and Jehovah, with all my soul and all my heart. Deign, O mighty Adonai, to accept it favorably. Now you can be sure you have the great almighty God, whatever his mystic name may be, firmly on your side. It is time to summon now the evil spirits. Have you scrupulously performed all that is required? Have you? Now, all right. Then begin to recite the following conjuration with confidence and assurance. I invoke and command thee, O cursed spirits. Ba'il, Ba'thim, Agares, Marbas, Pursan, Abigar, Amon, Botis, Valafar, Nuburus, Glassibolas. Come here to this place, instanter! Appear immediately in human form, well-shaped in body and soul, and comply with my commands without deception of whatever, whatsoever kind. Come then in visible form and speak pleasantly, so that I may understand thy words. Come in the name of Iod, Elioim, El, Elion Gibor, Vadath, El Adonai, Tzaboth, Elohim, Tzaboth, Shadi. If thou dost not come or disobey me in any way, I will curse thee and will cause thee to be consigned to the bottomless pit where thou wilt remain until the day of judgment. Come then, appear before this circle to obey me utterly. Come in the name of Adonai. Stand firm. Control your fears. One sign of fright and weakness and they'll set upon you. Giant toads. A two-legged rabbit hopping horribly. Beware, there's an Ethiopian giant jetting fire through his eyes with a darting tongue of flame 9 inches long. A three-headed cat. Look out. Snakes are gliding under the skirts of your robes, coiling around your legs. Blast them hence with your magic wand. Begone! You feel an invisible force pressing upon you? Exercise it. Be gone and banish, spirit of fear. I blast thee from this hallowed circle, a sanctuary, a place made safe. Shrink to nothing as I shrink the foul name of Shabriri, Briri, Riri, Iri, Ri, Oshnotinos, Shrotinos, Notinos, Dino, Hinos, Nos, Os. The invisible demon is gone. They are at bay, but they are ominous, imminent. There lurks a scaly dog without a tail, slimy green with yellow eyes, decapods and scorpions, cirripedes, scurrying mice. There a fantastic holothurian with a grinning head, a micaire with multiple claws, a rabid monkey with a cudgel, toothless hag, slithering reptilian on her belly. Take care! A beautiful dark-eyed girl, slinking seductively, smooth and voluptuous with silky hair and softly sloping flanks. She smiles. The smile of the succubus, salacious, her mouth, the awful gaping crimson mouth of hell, foul, toothless, spitting blood. There slithers now a monstrous slimy snake with the face of a newborn babe, indescribable monsters with outspread fins, bristling spikes like pterodactyls, spondylus, hogfish, flying crab beetles, disembodied bloodied heads, crawling like centipedes, bloated babies, branchiopods, triangular, horrible reptiles, porcupine scorpions, lizard cats, vampire bats, mocking imagination, flying red-eyed rats, fish-headed hunchback, groveling, grotesque, prancing, dancing, lovely, bloody, ghastly girls, hopping, throwing filth, a beautiful baboon in royal robes, flapping, flagellating, monstrous, diabolical, obscene, Hieronymus Bosch, sulfurous, putrid, livid, gangrenous, vaporous, phosphorescent enormity. And now they are still, subdued, obedient. Now you command these awful spirits to do what you desire. Perhaps to reveal a secret, to foretell the future, to lead you to some secret hiding place. Perhaps you command them to torment an enemy, or help a friend, or to enchant the person whose love you passionately desire. Sometimes a host of fiendish, unruly demons will appear in hideous, visible form, as you have just experienced, but sometimes only one or two spirits will appear, perhaps grotesque, or if you're lucky, in a reasonably agreeable form. At other times, you may only see a shadowy shape, or perhaps a bird, or a spider, or a bat. Spirits frequently appear as large buzzing flies, and sometimes you cannot see them at all, but you can only feel their presence. They're capricious. Their actions can never be anticipated with certainty. It depends to some extent upon the form of ritual used and the names of the spirits you call on to appear. As I've said, the most powerful conjurations carry the greatest peril, but that's only natural. The prudent novice in the art of conjuration will pick the spirits he wishes to summon with care and discretion. A few years ago, an undergraduate at Cambridge University, a man named Gerald Yorke, decided to experiment with necromancy. Well, after considerable study, he collected the necessary equipment and scrupulously following instructions, he worked on summoning Thoth, an ancient Egyptian god of wisdom and inspiration. He drew the circles, inscribed them, and intoned the magic formulae in his rooms at night. And then, to his great surprise, Thoth came. Other students who helped with the ritual saw him also, plainly and indisputably.